MBT. This is the King of Land Warfare, designed for direct fire combat. The MBT is a heavily armored, tracked vehicle with a large caliber main gun as its primary weapon. Its mission is to lead an assault, destroy other armored vehicles, and breach enemy fortifications. Modern tanks, like the American M1 Abrams, are defined by an optimal balance of three things: firepower, protection, and mobility. They are the decisive offensive weapon in a conventional war. Light tank. This is a category of tank that prioritizes mobility and speed over heavy armor. Light tanks are designed to be air transportable, allowing them to be deployed rapidly into areas where heavier main battle tanks cannot go. They often serve in a reconnaissance or light infantry support role, providing the firepower of a cannon on a much lighter chassis. Examples include the American M8 armored gun system, Russia's Sprut SD, and China's Type 15. In modern doctrine, they scout, screen, and create tempo, setting up breakthroughs for heavier armor. If you want to experiment with that combo, there's a way to try it yourself in a real-time grand strategy sandbox. I have been playing Supremacy World War III. It is a free online PvP strategy game where you lead a real country in modern global warfare. You build your army with tanks, jets, and submarines, and you face up to 99 real players in real time across campaigns that run for weeks. I started as Denmark and learned fast that neighbors watch your borders. Use diplomacy or brute force to shape the map, make alliances or declare wars, and plan your moves wisely as fronts shift day by day. You'll have to manage your nation's production and logistics, research new units and secret tech, and coordinate your moves via land, sea, and air to take key regions. What I like is the long-term planning against real people and the pressure of timing your pushes. It is cross-platform on PC and mobile. Right now, there is a seasonal storyline where a deadly mutation threatens humanity, with intelligent zombie variants coordinated by a hive mind and new drone motherships entering the fight. Dr. Pasar Shaitani may hold the key to survival or disaster. QR is on screen, and the link is in the description. Stick around for a bonus at the end. IFV. This vehicle's mission is to carry infantry into battle and then provide direct fire support. Unlike a simple transport, an IFV is heavily armed, typically with an autocannon capable of firing explosive rounds, machine guns, and anti-tank guided missiles. It is tracked and well-armored, allowing it to keep up with and fight alongside main battle tanks. The American M2 Bradley and the German Puma are quintessential examples. Think of it as a vehicle that both delivers troops and fights. APC. This is the battle taxi. An APC's main job is to transport a squad of infantry safely to the front line, protecting them from artillery shrapnel and small arms fire. While an IFV is a fighter, an APC is primarily a transport. It is more lightly armed, often with just a heavy machine gun for self-defense, and can have wheels, like the American Striker, or tracks, like the historic M113. They are a cost-effective way to motorize and protect infantry. MRAP. The MRAP is a specialized type of troop transport developed specifically for asymmetric warfare. Its defining feature is a V-shaped hull, which is designed to deflect the blast from an improvised explosive device or landmine away from the crew compartment. While not as mobile as a traditional APC, an MRAP provides vastly superior protection against underbelly blasts, making it the essential vehicle for transporting troops in a counterinsurgency environment. AAV. This is a specialized troop carrier designed to swim. An AAV is a fully amphibious, tracked vehicle that is launched from naval ships miles offshore and can propel itself through the water to land on a hostile beach. It is armored to protect the Marines or infantry inside as it crosses the dangerous open beach, and can then continue to fight and transport troops inland. The classic American AAV-7 and the high-speed Chinese ZBD-05 are quintessential examples. Self-propelled artillery. This is the Army's long-range heavy hitter, often called a self-propelled howitzer. It consists of a massive artillery cannon mounted on a tracked, armored chassis. Its purpose is to provide powerful, indirect fire on targets miles behind the front line. Because it is armored and mobile, it can keep pace with an advancing tank column, fire a mission, and then quickly move to a new position to avoid counter-battery fire. The South Korean K-9 Thunder and the German PZH-2000 are leading examples. MLRS. If a howitzer is a cannon, an MLRS is a mobile rocket battery. This vehicle carries a pod of rockets that can be fired in a rapid, devastating salvo, saturating a large area with explosive munitions. It is used to destroy soft targets like supply depots, enemy troop concentrations, and air defense sites. Modern systems like the American HIMARS can also fire long-range, precision-guided tactical ballistic missiles, making them a highly flexible and powerful asset. Self-propelled mortar carrier. This vehicle provides immediate, close-range, indirect fire support for infantry. It consists of a large-caliber mortar, typically 120 millimeters, mounted on a tracked or wheeled armored chassis, often with an automated loading system. Unlike a howitzer, which fires from miles away, a mortar carrier can keep up directly with the infantry and provide rapid, high-angle fire to drop explosive rounds behind walls or into enemy trenches, responding instantly to a frontline soldier's call for fire. Tank Destroyer. This is a specialized vehicle, often more lightly armored than a tank, but designed for one purpose: to hunt and kill enemy tanks. Modern tank destroyers are typically wheeled vehicles armed exclusively with powerful anti-tank guided missiles. They are designed to be fast, get into an ambush position, fire their missiles at enemy tanks from long range, and then quickly relocate. Examples include vehicles based on the Stryker chassis armed with TOW missiles. Assault gun. This is a direct fire weapon designed to support infantry in an attack. An assault gun is typically a large caliber cannon mounted on a lighter, more mobile chassis than a tank. Its job is to move with the infantry and destroy enemy bunkers, machine gun nests, and fortified positions with powerful high explosive rounds. While the concept is old, modern examples, sometimes called fire support vehicles, continue this mission. The Russian Sprut SD is a modern, air-droppable light tank / assault gun. Self-propelled anti-aircraft system. This is the guardian of the armored column, designed to protect friendly forces from air attack. These systems, also known as self-propelled anti-aircraft guns, are armed with rapid-firing autocannons and/or short-range surface-to-air missiles. Guided by an onboard radar, their job is to shoot down low-flying threats like attack helicopters and jets. The German Gepard and the Russian Panzer S-1 are famous examples. Self-propelled SAM system. While some anti-aircraft systems use guns, others rely exclusively on missiles. A self-propelled surface-to-air missile, or SAM system, is a vehicle designed to provide a mobile air defense umbrella. These tracked or wheeled vehicles are equipped with their own search radar and a launcher for multiple guided missiles capable of destroying aircraft and drones at much longer ranges than a gun system can. The Russian Tor and Buk missile systems are famous and formidable examples. Armored reconnaissance. This is the scout of the armored force. A reconnaissance or scout vehicle is designed for speed and stealth, not heavy combat. Its mission is to move ahead of the main force, use its advanced sensors, like thermal imagers and radar, to find the enemy, and report their location without getting into a fight. They are typically wheeled for speed and are armed just enough to defend themselves. The British Scimitar and the French AMX-10RC are classic examples. Armored car. This vehicle combines the speed of a wheeled APC with the firepower of a tank. An armored car or wheeled gun system is a multi-wheeled vehicle equipped with a large caliber, direct fire cannon, similar to that of a tank. They are not designed to fight tanks head-on, but to provide mobile fire support serve in a reconnaissance role, or rapidly destroy lighter targets. The Italian Centauro and the French AMX-10RC are prime examples of this fast, hard-hitting category. CEV. This is the heavy-duty workhorse of the battlefield. A CEV is a heavily armored vehicle, often built on a tank chassis, equipped with specialized tools to overcome obstacles. This typically includes a bulldozer blade, mine plow or roller, and explosive line charges for breaching. Bridging is usually performed by a related armored vehicle launched bridge. They are the combat engineers who clear the path for the tanks and infantry. ARV. This is the battlefield's tow truck. An ARV is another vehicle built on a tank chassis, but instead of a gun, it is equipped with a heavy-duty crane, winches, and repair tools. Its job is to go into a combat zone, under fire, to recover damaged or disabled armored vehicles, like a 70-ton main battle tank that has been hit, and tow it back to a safe location for repairs. It is one of the most important and unsung vehicles in any armored formation. Special thanks to Supremacy World War III for sponsoring this video. Click the link in the description or use the QR. New players get an exclusive starter pack with one free seasonal unit, the Elite Battle Tank. It is valued at $25 and available for 30 days. Supremacy World War III is free to play. Jump in, fight real players, and try to take the map.